Welcome back. You're watching Business Today. Well, just picking off on where we were before we took the break, we went to speak to Jackson Kinyanjui, who is the head of Resource Mobilization Department in the National Treasury. And of course, a lot has been happening when it comes to global partnerships. And let's just kick off this conversation, Mr. Kinyanjui, by talking to us about the upcoming conference slated for the 20th of November.
Thank you for having me, Abby.
As you know, Kenya is privileged to host the high-level meeting on global partnership. This is a meeting that brings together all actors of development cooperation. As this particular topic started from 2002 in Motre,
yes,
when there was a lot of discussion about transaction costs.
Mm-hmm.
How is the providers of aid and receivers of day aid doing business? And there are areas that we can reduce transaction costs to create the physical space to fund more programs.
Yeah.
And that also followed up another one in Paris in 2003, where the global community now are talking about the transaction costs, and they came up with some principles of monitoring how to reduce the transaction costs.
Mm-hmm.
And this has always been monitored through the global partnership monitoring survey. And that followed again in 2008 in Accra.
Okay.
Where we were also looking at how we are business. Yeah.
So what are really the objectives of this conference coming at a time where we're seeing with the election of Donald Trump, as my colleague Joy Doreed mentioned, when it comes to cutting off aid, how will African countries survive? I know right now aid constitutes not a significant portion of our budget, but really we still depend on aid for some certain projects.
I think, Abby, development aid is still significant to the extent that a lot of these resources come to fund our development projects. The objective of this meeting is really to bring together all the actors to try and see how we can do business differently. As you know, the last year, in September, the UN General Assembly adopted the 2030 Agenda.
Yes.
And the purpose of this is really to ensure that we address poverty in the whole world.
Yeah.
And Kenya is no exception. So we need to see how we can align these principles with our Vision 2030 to try and address poverty through ensuring that we implement all the programs that we have agreed in an efficient manner that gives results on the ground to Kenyans.
Mm-hmm.
So as the political situation in America is changing, certainly you also know that we have qualified as a lower middle income country.
Yeah.
It means that now we will not be able to get those cheap concessional financing that we used to get previously.
Yeah. Yeah.
And what means is that we have to look for alternative, innovative ways of funding our development. And one way is really to bring together other actors like the private sector, the civil society, the philanthropies, to try and see how we can create synergy in terms of financing our programs. And this particular meeting, the HLM meeting that is going to take place from 28th,
yeah,
is really bringing all these actors together,
mm-hmm,
to try and see how we can partner and fund our programs and our projects to realize our development objectives.
Interesting. And Kinyanjui, before we wrap it up, of course, the bigger question is, what does Kenya stand to gain out of it? Are we likely to see some form of partnerships being struck and also funding new revenue lines in the sense that a few of these countries that will be taking part will be able to agree on one thing or the other?
Certainly, we will share our experiences as a country, the challenges that we are facing. We are also having a marketplace where our exhibitors, our Kenyan producers, will exhibit their products, and most likely this will create some business opportunities for our people on the sidelines of the meeting. We shall also be advancing the cause of youth and women in this country. You know, this is a huge resource in this country.
Yeah.
And we shall be championing these discussions in the meeting. and hopefully this will attract some support from well-wishers to fund these particular programs, particularly creating employment for our people and empowering women who are a sizable population, part of our population.
Interesting.
Yes.
And just as you wrap it up, what's your outlook for foreign direct investment in the coming financial year?
I think given the macroeconomic situation of our country, which has been very stable, it has been growing steadily in the last couple of years, we do expect that we will continue to realize FDIs, increased FDIs in Kenya, given that we are creating an enabling environment for investment in Kenya. It will certainly attract more investors to come in Kenya, and this will certainly realize more FDIs into the country.
Fantastic. Many thanks there, Jackson Kinyanjui, who is the Director for Resource Mobilization at the National Treasury, just talking to us about the upcoming Global Partnership Conference that will be trying to put together policymakers to discuss new funding models.